हेलो 10th स्टैंडर्ड। फ्रॉम मैनी वीडियोज वी आर वर्किंग ऑन ज्योग्राफी लेसन नंबर 10, राइट? ऑलमोस्ट 7 वीडियोज आर अपलोडेड फॉर लेसन नंबर 10। सो नाउ दिस विल बी 8th वीडियो एंड आई मोस्ट प्रोबेबली आई कैन से दिस इज द लास्ट वीडियो रिलेटेड टू लेसन नंबर 10, इन विच वी विल complete our last topic. Along with that, we will just go through, recall the whole lesson once, and then we will work with question answers in this as well. Okay, so let's go with impact of globalization in Indian agriculture. Now, what is globalization? That is internationally, we can tell import and export takes place. By sitting in India, we can use seeds of other countries, and we can use machineries and technology which is developed or manufactured in other countries and all that easily we can import to our country, and we can use those, right? So let us read. The policy of globalization has been implemented with the purpose that the Indian farmers can sell his farm product in world market and earn profit. So globalization ka main maksad yahi tha ke farmers jo hai wo Indian products grow kare aur dusri countries tak wo products beche jaye aur farmers bhi acha profit kama sake. Many changes took place in agricultural field due to globalization. Globalization ki wajah se kafi changes हुए एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड में. द प्रोसेस टू एक्सपोर्ट और इम्पोर्ट क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन इज़ मेड वेरी सिंपल. सो क्रॉप वहाँ फॉरेन कंट्रीज से इंडिया में आना, दैट इज़ इम्पोर्ट, एंड यहाँ से इंडिया से फॉरेन कंट्री में जाना, दैट इज़ एक्सपोर्ट. सो इम्पोर्ट एक्सपोर्ट की एक्टिविटीज़ काफ़ी ली गई थी बाय ऑल द कंट्रीज ऑलमोस्ट. कॉटन, चिलीज and till are now available in Chinese market, and various fruits from world are now available in Indian market. So कई ऐसे product हैं जो सिर्फ इंडिया में होते हैं और वो अलग अलग countries में भी अब supply होने लगे हैं. And along with this, there are many such products which are not produced in India, but it is available in India. That is all due to globalization. The costly genetical modified BT seeds sold by the multinational companies are now available in India. We can tell branded seeds which other developed countries are using, those seeds are also now in available in India. Due to this, farming become costly. Definitely ab foreign country se koi seeds, koi machinery mangwayenge तो उनका एक्सपेंस तो थोड़ा ज़्यादा ही होगा. सो जिसकी वजह से फार्मिंग जो है वो थोड़ा कॉस्टली होना, फार्मिंग एक्टिविटी बिकम लिटल कॉस्टली. द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉटन एंड मेज़ हैज़ इंक्रीज्ड. कॉटन और मेज़ की प्रोडक्शन ज़्यादा इंक्रीज होने लगी. विद द इम्पोर्ट बिकमिंग स्मूथर, द डोमेस्टिक फार्म प्रोडक्ट्स हैव टू फेस टफ कॉम्पिटिशन. Now this line is completely changing the scenario. Actually globalization is very good, lekin globalization ki wajah se we can tell small farmers and which farmers are not capable to take machines and all, expensive machines and all from big factories and all, right? So somewhere they people suffer, and somewhere they people face tough competition. Even some products have import becoming smooth, okay, sorry, some products have gained global market, hence the necessity of registration of their patents. Patents we can tell ek order number diya hota hai, like hum har ek ka naam to yaad nahi rakh sakte. In the same way aap logon ko bhi school mein, class mein roll numbers diye jate hain, right? Your identity, your roll number become your identity in school. Okay, so usi tarah se which crop is going to be in global market have been given patent number. It is necessary to register qualitative farm production as national patent in the world market. So jo bhi farm production bahut hi good quality mein produce hota hai, तो उसका जो ये पेटेंट नंबर है दैट इज़ टू बी रजिस्टर्ड इन वर्ल्ड मार्केट. ओके, नाउ द लास्ट पैराग्राफ इज़ ऑलमोस्ट कंक्लूजन. टू फेस द कॉम्पिटिशन इन एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोडक्ट्स इन ग्लोबल मार्केट इंडिया विल हैव टू अडॉप्ट न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी एंड कंसनट्रेट ऑन क्वालिटी. सो ग्लोबल मार्केट में दूसरी कंट्रीज़ के सामने टफ कॉम्पिटिशन की तरह अगर आना है तो इंडिया हैव टू अडॉप्ट न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इट हैज़ टू गो ऑन विद गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ सीड्स एज वेल. अ सीरीज ऑफ प्लैंड स्टेप्स विल हैव टू बी टेकन टू इंक्रीज द इकोनॉमिक प्रॉस्पेरिटी एंड सॉलिडरिटी ऑफ पीपल. सो सीरीज ऑफ प्लैंड स्टेप्स, ओके, जितने भी प्लैंड स्टेप्स, काफ़ी गवर्नमेंट काफ़ी स्टेप्स लेते हैं एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड में प्रोग्रेस करने का. सो ऑल दोज प्रोग्रेसिव स्टेप्स शुड बी टेकन फॉर वेल्थ ऑफ इंडिया एंड फॉर प्रोग्रेस ऑफ पीपल एज वेल. विद इंक्रीज पॉपुलेशन द प्रोबेबली फ्यूचर इंक्रीज इन द डिमांड फॉर एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्ट एंड टू मेंटेन द मार्च टू इकोनॉमिक प्रोग्रेस इट इज़ नेसेसरी टू अरेंज द स्ट्रेटजी फॉर सेकेंड ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन. सी ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन ऑलरेडी इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ है इंडिया में, काफ़ी न्यू वेराइटीज़ ऑफ सीड्स एंड मशीन्स वगैरह इंट्रोड्यूस हुए, फर्टिलाइजर्स, केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स इंट्रोड्यूस हुए, बट समवेयर स्टिल देयर इज़ नीड टू अपग्रेड एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटीज स्टिल इन इंडिया टू स्टैंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज रिगार्डिंग एग्रीकल्चरल एंड ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स. ओके, तो उसके लिए ज़रूरत अभी भी है कि सेकेंड ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन भी होना चाहिए और ज़्यादा टेक्नोलॉजी और ज़्यादा मतलब गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ क्रॉप्स ग्रो हो सके. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ स्टेप्स टू बी टेकन बाय गवर्नमेंट स्टिल. ओके, सो दिस इज़ योर लेसन नंबर 10. ओके, दिस इज़ लिटिल लेंथी लेसन बट इट्स नॉट दैट, इट्स क्वाइट ईजी, इन ईजी लैंग्वेज इट इज़ रिटन, राइट. सो लेट्स रिकॉल, फर्स्ट वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ फार्मिंग. In types of farming, we have studied there are 6 types of farming: subsistence farming, dry farming, wet farming, shifting or zoom agriculture, plantation agriculture, and intensive farming. Okay. Then in this much I had explained in first video. In second video, I have gone through from farming method. Okay. That is, there are 3 types of farming methods: organic farming, sustainable farming and mixed farming. Okay, after this in third video we discussed about crops of matlab seasonal crops, that is kharif monsoon crop, ravi winter crops and zaid summer crops. Okay, not only that, we even went with major agricultural crops, that is we discussed about whole this topic, major agricultural products of India, food grains and paddy and wheat. Okay, then further in my next video we discussed about jowar, right, we discussed about jowar. Okay, along with jowar then in my next video we discussed about certain other crops, that is grains, that is bajra, maize, pulses, etc., right. Along with this, next, this bluish box was your self study related to nagli. Okay, and then I continued with the oil seeds, that is related to groundnuts, sesame or til, mustard, then coconut and castor oil. Okay, then later we discussed about hot beverages, discussed about tea, coffee and cocoa. Now after discussing about hot beverages, we discussed about cash crops: cotton, then sugar cane, then jute and then tobacco, rubber, okay, condiments and spices, fruits, vegetables and flowers. This was regarding crops. Okay, next we started with the technical and institutional reforms of agriculture. किस तरह के इंस्टीट्यूशनल चेंजेस आए हैं एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटी में. So technical reforms we discussed and institutional reforms. Later we discussed the meaning and all the points regarding green revolution, right? After we discussed about green revolution and all plus points about green revolution, we studied the role of agricultural in Indian economy. So all these points we had gone through, role of agriculture, Indian economy mein. And the last topic which we completed today was impact of globalization of India on Indian agriculture. Okay, so this was finally lesson number 10, that is third lesson of your geography. So here are certain questions. I have written four questions with pen also. Okay, that is first one is green revolution. Second, give information about types of farming. Third, mention the technical reforms brought in Indian agriculture. And fourth, why is it necessary to secure the food grains in India today? Okay, so these four extra questions, because these topics are not covered in your exercise questions. So with these four, I want you people to do with question number one, that is answer in detail. Question number two, that is up to the point, right? And question number three on page number 89, it is, that is answer in brief. MCQs, you can go on with textbook only, no need to write in notebook. But see that you complete writing question answers, especially in your notebook of lesson number 10. Okay? I will upload picture of this question and questions so that you can write your answers of these questions in notebook. Okay, everyone? So, see that you go through videos. I repeat once again, I uploaded total 8 videos related to this lesson, okay? Because I went with one single topic so that you can understand each and every topic easily, right? So please go through each and every topic, understand the topics well, and then go on writing these question answers also. Take care everyone and study well.